So it seems our understanding of insects has changed. We used to think of insects as being highly sedentary, and that's become clear that many of them migrate. So Erica, why have these views changed?
Well, we've known, for example, that some do. The classic examples are with the butterflies. So we get the monarch migrations. We understand a lot about that. We've been tracking that for years. The dragonflies. These are all big, conspicuous species. But actually, recent work that's come out of the University of Exeter and other places has showed that actually it's a lot smaller ones. In fact, it's the flies that are dominating our skies. Mm-hmm. So there's been some brilliant studies looking at, for example, hoverflies. Within the tribe of Serfini, and these are really good migrators. And as they're migrating, they're pollinating as they go because they're quite polyphagous, mm-hmm. so they're all everywhere getting their tarsar in. But some of them, because it's multiple generations, they're dying on the way here, so that's adding nitrogen in the soil, so already two amazing things going on. And when they turn up here, there is a lot of mixing with the resident populations of these different hoverflies, which creates a much higher fecundity. So they're producing way more eggs. And this is important because their eggs will develop into the larvae, which are larvae predate on aphids. So they're controlling our crop species and mm-hmm. all those pests as well that are trying to munch on that. So this is a brilliant example of how we need to pay, why we need to pay attention to what's going on.
And it's satisfying that the painted lady story was that they bred in Central Africa, and then they came north in the spring with a number of generations and arrived here and then just died, which from an evolutionist point of view is bonkers.
Yeah.
And it's very satisfying that recently that people have discovered if they go up to 500 meters and then belt south.
Yeah.
And you can't see them.
So no, lots of lovely research is coming out of the same cohort mm-hmm. of researchers are showing that actually there's this part in the Pyrenees, between the Pyrenees, where they filter all of them through, mm-hmm. that they're able to actually physically count a lot mm-hmm. of the insects, mm-hmm. which is amazing. And they're finding all of these species on their return leg. So we can finally put that little myth to bed.
So I guess for other migrants, like bird migration, we've realised the importance of protecting all the bits, protecting the migrational yeah. pathway. And I guess for insects, we then need to think the same way. It's
yeah.
not just about protecting in this one location, but thinking about protecting a network of sites as they move south.
Yeah, and we've got to think about how climate's going to impact, because that is going to change all these air currents, all these patterns mm-hmm. that these migrants are coming in. So we do have to think global about our local insects.